an absolutely massive week is expected from Manchester United this week. Five players could be out. Scott McTominay, Facundo Pellistri, Victor Lindelof, Christian Eriksen, and Jadon Sancho. Welcome to the channel. In this video, we're going to dissect some interesting news that has come out, and we're also going to speak about what a huge week this could be for Manchester United in the transfer window, specifically for outgoings. Player number one, the most important player, I think, the player that generates the most interest, the player that could possibly generate the most money, Scott McTominay. Now, Scott McTominay has been the topic of discussion for quite a while now, but the most interesting story came out on the weekend, which was on Sunday, that he has agreed personal terms with Napoli. As soon as this story broke, another story from Sky Sports News broke about 15 or 20 minutes later that Fulham were now back in the race for Scott McTominay. Now, this is absolutely great for Manchester United, because are we going to see a bidding war, or are Fulham just going to win because they can offer money? At the moment, Napoli are looking to do a loan to buy deal for Scott McTominay, which in my personal opinion is not something that I want Man United to go for. But if they do, that's okay. But what this has done is it has now forced Fulham to come in for possibly a third bid for Scott McTominay. And it could be what Man United are looking for, 25 million plus 5 in add-ons. Now, this could be absolutely massive for a move on Manuel Ugarte if Scott McTominay is to go. The fact that Napoli are interested, but only on a loan deal, could still make it tricky for Manuel Ugarte to come. That's why I'm extremely excited and happy about the fact that Fulham are now back in the race to sign McTominay. And Sky Sports News are extremely good when it comes to Fulham. They were the first ones to break the Emile Smith Rowe deal, and for the past few years, they have been really close to Fulham. So there could be a lot of truth in this, and I'm hoping that it is Fulham, because they can actually pay a fee for McTominay up front, whereas Napoli are just looking for a loan deal. So that's the thing on Scott McTominay. Scott McTominay is our most valuable player in terms of the money that he could bring in. He is a decent player, but I'd love to see him go. Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Next is Facundo Pellistri. Obviously, Pellistri from the youth setup, young player, was never really given the chance, was he? I don't think Erik ten Hag was that into him from the beginning, but he has been approached by Panathinaikos in Greece, and he could be on his way there this week for a small fee of about 8 to 12 million euros, so we're told. But that would be a good move for him. He'll be able to play regular football and get out on the pitch. Obviously, it just hasn't worked out for him at Manchester United. He was an exciting prospect, but some things are just not meant to be. And in the real world, when things are not meant to be, you have to move on, I guess. So on Pellistri, Panathinaikos are extremely interested in him. That could also happen this week. Very, very possible to happen this week. Then this is a really interesting one. Victor Lindelof. A picture came out on Saturday of Victor Lindelof currently on crutches. Now, this is not very good, considering there is interest from Fiorentina. This is not good that he's on crutches. Will a team still sign him when he's injured? We obviously don't know much about the injury. We've just seen the picture of him on crutches. Now, Victor Lindelof is also a player that is quite far down the pecking order when it comes to defenders. But unfortunately, he is currently injured. And like I said, we don't know how long this injury is going to last. And with Fiorentina being interested, there were a few teams interested as well, but this Fiorentina's name has been mentioned the most. Will they still be interested if it is just a short-term injury? But if it's not, he's obviously going to stay. So this is a really interesting one for me, because now it kind of is, it throws a spanner in the works, because now if he is injured, does he stay till January? Does he stay for the rest of the season? This is a really, really strange one for me, and I really hope that he's not injured for too long and a deal can still be done with Fiorentina or with whoever wants to come and get him so that he can just leave. and he can be off our wage bill. But we'll see what happens when that happens. We obviously don't know much yet on the story and what the injury is. What is it? Was it a surgery? Is it a knock he picked up? We don't know because he's on crutches. So I'm guessing that story will develop more and more this week. And as it develops, we'll speak about it as it comes out as well. Our next player is Christian Eriksen. Now, Christian Eriksen, I've mentioned this before, has made public knowledge that he is okay to be a utility player coming off the bench and being involved. Now, realistically, Erik ten Hag prefers Scott McTominay to Christian Eriksen. And some reports have mentioned that Erik ten Hag actually wants to keep Scott McTominay. Now, this is extremely interesting when it comes to Christian Eriksen, because if Erik ten Hag could choose, he get rid of Christian Eriksen and keep Scott McTominay, because McTominay is a bit more explosive coming off the bench. Unfortunately, Sir Jermaine Enos see money to be made from Scott McTominay. He has a market value, whereas Christian Eriksen does not have such a big market value. But they'd still be looking to get rid of both of them. Now, Christian Eriksen, like I said, is okay with being a bench utility player, but I don't think the club want that either. They want to get rid of that £120,000 wage that he is on and free up some sort of funds. If we could get 10 million euros for Christian Eriksen, I think that would be a very good deal to any team, Premier League or in outer Europe. It doesn't matter to me wherever he goes. There was interest from Italy and Turkey. I'm not really too bothered where he goes. I think he should move on. And I know that the Ineos hierarchy will be looking to get rid of both him and Scott McTominay, although Erik ten Hag really wants to keep Scott McTominay. Another interesting story to keep our eyes on this week. I definitely do know that there will be a lot of movement, a lot of stories coming out. A lot of clubs will be making their interest known even more, because the transfer window closes in about 11 days or so. So it's very, very soon. Our last player is an extremely interesting one. And I know I'd probably be in the majority on this one, wanting him to leave, is Jadon Sancho. Jadon Sancho, firstly, let's start off with this, was not in the squad due to sinus, or he's ill. He was ill. He had some sort of cold or flu, whatever it is, but he wasn't in the squad. Obviously, if you delve a bit deeper into this, there's two ways to look at it. One, he does get ill quite often. He has been ill quite a few times for Man United in these past 2.5 years. So that possibly is true. The other thing that is true is that he's really trying to force a move, which I am happy for. I'm happy if he's trying to force the move. Unfortunately, a few clubs have really cooled their interest in him. The Chelsea thing was never real, although it was extremely exciting. PSG have also cooled down. Dortmund don't have the money. Juventus don't have the money. So what could possibly happen again is another loan spell. I'm sure he'd love to go to Dortmund again. It's one of his favorite clubs to play for. Juventus were also interested. Obviously, PSG. A lot of us were hoping for PSG because they seemed like the club with the actual money to pay a fee for him and to take him and to pay his wage. But they've also cooled their interest quite a bit. Obviously, they're still looking to get rid of Ugarte as well, who's hoping to come to us. So Jadon Sancho is an extremely interesting one. Maybe kind of a bit of a wild card, although I do think it's very possible that he goes out on loan somewhere at some point. Who knows? Who knows what might happen? But I think the interesting thing that we have to keep considering is that Man United have to get at least three players out before anyone comes in. There are a few names being mentioned again, the same names: Jared Branthwaite, Ivan Toney, Manuel Ugarte, Sufyan Amrabat, that were still very, very interesting. Kadioglu's just come out as well. So, but for us to get moving on these players, we need to get moving on outgoings. Which could be tricky on a few players, but on some players, I'm expecting a year we go for Scott McTominay this week. And I'd also expect a year we go for Balestri this week. And we might even get a terms agreed for Victor Lindelof this week. So I'm going to be keeping really close tabs on that because I really think it is extremely possible for us to get 3 here-we-goes this week on outgoing. So we'll keep close tabs on that. Remember to subscribe to the channel if you enjoy the content. Smash a like on this video and I'll see you in the next one.